Thank you. Is Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Yeah.
ISKCON Founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Yeah.
Nitya Lila Pravishta Om Vishnupad Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasati Thakur Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Yeah.
Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda Ki.
Yeah.
Nam Acharya Srila Haridas Thakur Ki.
Yeah.
Prem Shri Gaur Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadata Shri Vasa Gaur Bhakta Vinda Ki. Shri Shri Radha Krishna Gopa Gopinath Shyam Kund Radha Kund Giri Govardhan Ki. Vrindavan Mayapur Dham Ki. Ganga Mai Yamuna Mai Ki. Tosi Maharani Bhakti Devi Ki. Hari Nam Sankirtan Ki. All glories to Sambhu devotees. All glories to Sambhu devotees. All glories to Sambhu devotees. All glory Sri Guru Sri Gauranga, all glory Srila Prabhupada. Namo Vishnupadaya, Krishna Pristaya Bhutale, Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namane, Namaste Sarasati Devi, Gauravani Pracharini, Nirvishesha Shunyavadi, Paschacha Desha Tarine. Okay. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Naram chaiva narottamam Devim sarasatim vyasam Tato jayamudirayat Nasta prayeshu vabhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki So Srimad Bhagavatam, we have Narada Muni speaking to Srila Vyasadeva. And he was talking about the power of chanting the holy name of the Lord. Narada Muni was describing that whenever he chants the glories of the Lord, then he immediately can feel the presence of the Lord sitting on his heart.
那儿的牧尼描述说，每当他唱诵主的圣名的时候，他便立刻可以感觉到主就坐在他的内心之中。
So Narada Muni is a great acharya in the chanting of the holy name.
Narada Muni 是一位唱诵圣名的伟大的 acharya.
He was given a tambura, and he would take it with him everywhere and play his tambura and at the same time chant the glories of the Lord.
他被赐予了一把 tambura, 他一边弹奏着 tambura, 一边在所有的地方去唱诵主的荣耀。
And Lord Krishna appreciates that he's chanting his name.
而且主 Krishna 非常的欣赏他对于他的圣名的唱诵。
Lord Krishna says, Naham tishtani vaikunte yogi nam vidayeshuva tatra tishtani narada yatra gayanti madbhakta. The Lord is saying that I am not in the hearts of the yogis who meditate on me, and I'm not in Vaikuntha.
主 Krishna 说，我并不在那些冥想我的 yogi 们的心中，我也不在 Vaikuntha.
But I am wherever my devotees like Narada are chanting my holy name.
但只要有像 Narada 那样的奉献者在唱诵我的圣名，我就会在那个地方。
So I was thinking, it's so nice to be in Mayapur.
我在想，在马尔普真是太好了。
I was talking to devotees in Russia, and I said, "How is it there?" I said, "How's the weather there?" They said, "Oh, it's a little warmer today. It's minus 10."
我跟俄罗斯的奉献者一起交谈，我就问他们，今天你们那儿的天气怎么样？他们说，哦，今天暖和一些了，零下十度。
So very fortunate to be in the holy Dham, Mayapur, where everybody likes to chant the holy name.
我们非常幸运能够待在神圣的 Dham, Mayapur, 在这里每一个人都喜欢唱诵主的圣名。
The chanting of the holy name, of course, Lord Chaitanya appeared here more than 500 years ago.
大人提到唱诵圣名，主 Chaitanya 便显现在这里五百多年之前。
Not very far away from here, just down the road.
离这儿并不远，就在路的那头。
The Yoga Pit.
叫 Yoga Pit.
Yoga is a place, union, where the Lord comes to this world, where he connects to this world.
Yoga 的意思是连接，也就是主到这个世界来，跟这个世界有关系的地方。
So the Lord came externally, the purpose was to propagate the Yoga Dharma, the chanting of the holy name.
主到来的外在的目的就是传播 Yoga Dharma, 传播主的圣名。
Of course, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj describes other reasons why the Lord came.
在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 之中 ，Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami 描述了主到来的其他原因。
But externally was to perform sankirtan.
但外在的是为了举行 Sankirtan.
And Lord Chaitanya chanted the holy names, did Sankirtan here for the first 24 years of his manifest pastimes.
主 Chaitanya 在这里，在他生命展示中的前24年做了 Sankirtan.
When we go on the Parikrama around Navadvip,then these are the different places where Lord Chaitanya would go with the Sankirtan party.
当我们在 Navadvip 周围做 Parikrama 绕拜的时候，我们可以看到主 Chaitanya 跟他的 Sankirtan 的队伍曾经到过的地方。
He'd go to all the different islands.
会去各种不同的岛屿。
Go and visit the different devotees in the different places.
访问不同的奉献者，访问不同的地点。
And some often he would go with the Sankirtan devotees. They would go as a party chanting.
他经常会跟 Sankirtan 的奉献者们一起去，作为一个队伍，一边唱诵一边去。
Sometimes he would just go with Lord Nityananda.
有的时候他会跟 Nityananda 一起去。
Sometimes with Lord Nityananda, they would go all the way to Shantipur to visit Advaita Acharya.
有的时候跟尼天南的一起，他们会一路去 Shantipur 访问 Advaita Acharya。
And sometimes it would just go by swimming in the Ganga.
有的时候他通过在恒河里游泳去。
So Lord Chaitanya made this place very special for all the devotees.
主柴坦涅使这个地方对于所有的奉献者来说呢都是非常特殊的。
That we could come here, well, of course, Srila Prabhupada also selected this place as the headquarters for the ISKCON Society.
当然 ，Srila Prabhupada 也选择了这个地方作为 ISKCON 协会的一个总部。
And Srila Prabhupada then instructed his wealthiest disciple, namely Ambarish Prabhu, that he should develop Mayapur.
Srila Prabhupada 教导他最富有的门徒，名字是 Ambarish Prabhu， 让他来发展 Mayapur。
So we are seeing the temple of the Vedic planetarium gradually manifest itself.
这样我们看到伟大天文馆的庙宇逐渐的在展示出来。
And we hope that the temple will be completed soon.
我们希望这个庙宇能够很快的盖好。
We don't know exactly how long it will take.
但我们不知道具体要花多久的时间。
Very special circumstances the world is going through just now with the pandemic.
因为这个世界现在经历一个特殊的情况，那就是疫情。
But still, Krishna consciousness.Is not material, doesn't depend on any material situation.
但仍然 ，Krishna 知觉并不是物质的，并不依靠任何物质的情况。
When Prabhupada first met Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, it was in Calcutta.
当 Prabhupada 第一次见到 Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati 的时候，是在加尔各答。
Was at a place called Uttadanga.
那个地方的名字叫做 Uttadanga.
Now, in the recent times, they purchased that land and they've established a preaching center there.
最近，大家把那个地方买了下来，并且在那里建设了一个传播的中心。
And they've also purchased the birthplace of Srila Prabhupada.
而且大家还买下了 Srila Prabhupada 的出生地。
Which is also, of course, Calcutta, but different from Uttadanga.
当然那里也是在加尔各答不过跟乌特当格不在同一个地方
And they're going to have the opening of that birthplace in the coming year
而且在明年的时候大家要举行一个帕帕德出生地的开幕式典礼
Because it's 100th and let's see
This year, 125 Srila Prabhupada's birth anniversary.
This year is 125. So they're planning to do it on. Is it work? When are they planning? I thought they were going to do it. Anyway, it's in this coming year, the new year.
无论如何，应该是在新年新的一年里就会做这个开幕仪式。
Prabhupada's disappearance, 1977, there's 23. But anyway, the birthplace, Prabhupada's birthplace in Calcutta, they've also purchased, and they're going to have a big program for the opening of that center there, the birthplace.
无论如何，大家把释罗帕帕德的出生地已经买了下来，而且呢，这个出生地会有一个开幕典礼，是会举行一个很隆重的仪式。
So we see Calcutta also becoming more of a holy place.
我们可以看到加尔各答也正在成为一个神圣的地方。
Recently, His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj gave, I think, 5 days seminars, 5 days classes on Calcutta, the holy dam.
最近呢 ，Radhanath Maharaj 他讲了一个五天的一个讲座。专门就讲加尔各答如何是一个神圣的 dam。
What makes a place holy?
到底什么能够让一个地方成为圣地
？Bhavadvida Bhagavatas Tirtha Bhuta Swayam Vibho Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani Swantasthena Gadabhridaha. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is described by Maharaj Yudhisthira, who is speaking to Vidura.
在 Srimad Bhagavatam 之中 Maharaj Yudhisthira 他在跟 Vidura 讲话。
Vidura had been traveling to the holy places for many years.
Vidura 多年以来一直在朝拜圣地。
He had been thrown out of Hastinapur by Duryodhan.
他被 Duryodhan 赶出了 Hastinapur.
Vidura was actually uncle to Duryodhan.
Vidura 实际上是 Duryodhan 的叔叔。
But Vidura was telling the father of Duryodhan, Dhritarashtra, don't listen to this.Son of yours, he's very demonic. You shouldn't listen to him. Don't let him influence you.
Vidura 告诉 Dhritarashtra, 你不要听你这个儿子的话，因为他是非常有恶魔倾向的人。你不应该要让他来影响你。
Duryodhana was saying, "Don't give any land to the Pandavas. Don't listen to Krishna."
Duryodhana 说，不要给 Pandava 任何的土地，不要听 Krishna 的。
And Vidura was saying, you should listen to Krishna, and you should give land to the Pandavas, and you shouldn't have a war.
And Vidura 说你们应该听 Krishna 的，应该把土地给 Pandava 们，不应该打仗。
But Duryodhana was telling his father, don't listen to Vidura.
但是 Duryodhana 告诉他的父亲，不要听 Vidura 的。
And Duryodhana told Vidura, get out from here before I whip you, I whip you. I feel like beating you. Just get out of here.Don't ever come here.
Duryodhana 告诉 Vidura, 你赶快从这儿给我滚开，在我拿鞭子抽你之前，我想揍你一顿，不要再到这个地方来。
So Vidura saw both Yoga Maya and Mahamaya.
Vidura 看到了 Yoga Maya 和 Mahamaya 两者。
He saw the Mahamaya influencing Duryodhana, that he was behaving in this way and rejecting the good advice of Vidura.
他看到玛哈玛雅在影响Duryodhana，因为他拒绝了好的建议。
But he saw also Yoga Maya. In fact, this is very nice. This is Krishna's arrangement.
但是他也看到了 Yoga Maya， 他看到这很好，这是 Krishna 的安排。
That Krishna's giving me an opportunity to go and visit all the holy places.
Krishna 给了我一个机会，可以朝拜所有的圣地。
I can go and meet all the great saintly persons who live there.
我可以去访问住在那些地方的圣人们。
It's a great opportunity for me to purify myself.
这个对于我来讲真是一个太好的机会，可以让我能够得到净化。
And we could also be thinking the same thing about staying in Mayapur.
我们住在 Mayapur 也可以有同样的想法。
We could think of Yoga Maya and Mahamaya.
我们可以想着 Yoga Maya 还有 Mahamaya.
Yeah, there's Mahamaya.This disease, this pandemic, this situation, so much disease everywhere, people all afraid to get this disease.
Mahamaya 的那一面就是现在有这个疾病，有这个疫情，然后所有的人都非常的害怕这个疾病。
And all the countries closing the borders and stopping the flights.
所有的国家关闭边界，并且停止航班。
And we could think, oh, this is Mahamaya.
我们可以想着这是 Mahamaya，
but we can also think this is Yoga Maya。
但我们也可以想这是 Yoga Maya。
That Krishna is giving us the chance to stay in the holy dham and to purify ourselves。
Krishna 给我们一个机会，可以住在神圣的 dham， 可以净化我们自己。
To go and see Radha Madhava and Astasaki and Panchatattva and Lord Nrisingadev。
可以去看 Radha Madhava, Astasakhi, Panchatattva, 还有 Dhru Nrisingadev.
To take part in so many wonderful festivals.
去参与各种各样的奇妙的节日。
Have the association of so many senior devotees.
可以得到众多高级奉献者们的联谊。
There's so much opportunity for our spiritual progress.
为了我们的灵性进步，可以有很多的机会。
Other devotees.Other devotees who are not here, they're all eager to come here.
那些不在这儿的奉献者们全都非常的迫切想到这里来。
And they all think you're so lucky to be there.
他们全都认为你们太幸运了，能够待在 Mayapur.
So we have to take advantage of this very special good fortune to be here in this holy dham.
我们应该好好的利用这个特殊的幸运，就是能够住在神圣的 dham。
Holy places are about Maharaj Yudhisthira was telling Vidura that you are the personification of the holy place。
关于圣地 ，Maharaj Yudhisthira 告诉 Vidura， 你就是圣地的人格化身。
Because you carry the Lord in your heart，
因为你的内心承载着主。
So wherever you go， you purify that place。
因此，无论你去什么地方，你都会净化那个地方。
It's the devotees who make this a holy place。
据说，是奉献者才会让一个地方成为圣地。
It's the devotees who come. The devotees come first, then the temple comes.
是先有奉献者来，然后才会出现庙宇。
Sometimes people, you go to a city and people say, "Oh, where's your temple? Where's your temple?"
有的时候你去一个城市，然后人们就问，问你们的庙在哪儿？你们的庙在哪儿
？Oh, we don't have any temple yet.
我们还没有庙呢。
First the devotees come, then the temple comes.
首先有奉献者来，然后才会出现庙宇。
It's not that you get the temple and then the devotees come.
不是说你先建好了庙，然后才有奉献者来。
First the devotees came here.
先得有奉献者来这儿。
Prabhupada came here when there was nothing here, just rice fields.
Prabhupada 到了这里，当时这里什么都没有，只有一片一片的稻田。
Of course, Jayapataka Swami Maharaj, he also came very, very early in this the development of Mayapur.
当然还有加帕塔克马哈拉吉，他也是在马耶普发展的早期就到了这里。
And other a few other devotees, Janani Vas Prabhu, very early also.
还有其他少数几位奉献者，比如 Janani Vas Prabhu 也是很早。
So they are the ones who make this holy place.
是他们把这个地方变成了圣地。
By their dedication and purity，
通过他们的献身精神以及他们的纯粹。
By their mood of giving service, selfless service for the pleasure of Krishna，
通过他们的这种情感，就是要无私的为 Krishna 做服务。
Right, pure devotional service is described by Rupa Goswami. Anya bilasi sita sunyam jnana karma janavritam.Anukuyena Krishna Nushilanam Bhaktir Uttamam. The devotional service should be without any material desire or philosophical speculation.
纯粹的奉献服务由Srila Rupa Goswami定义如下，应该是免于任何物质的愿望，而且是免于任何的哲学思辨。
It should be performed simply for the pleasure of Lord Krishna.
应该仅仅为了 Krishna 的，就是仅仅应该为了取悦 Krishna 而进行。
It should be favorable to Krishna.
而且应该是顺意，按照 Krishna 的意愿。
Kamsa was always thinking of Krishna, but he was always thinking how to kill Krishna.
Kamsa 也一直想着 Krishna, 但他想的是如何杀了 Krishna.
So his remembrance of Krishna was not considered pure devotional service.
他对 Krishna 的意念并不认为是纯粹的奉献服务。
We want to practice pure devotional service.
我们想修习的是纯粹奉献服务。
We want to transcend the modes of nature.
我们想超越物质自然属性。
We want to feel the present. We want to feel Krishna consciousness.
我们想感受到 Krishna 知觉。
Somebody was saying to me this morning.They were saying that when I chant, I don't feel very happy.
今天早上有人告诉我说，当我唱诵的时候，我觉得不是特别高兴。
They said, "You know, the devotee said, I used to chant five rounds. When I chanted five rounds, I felt good."
然后这个奉献者说呢，我常常唱诵五圈，等我念诵了，就是五圈之后，我觉得感觉挺不错的。
So now I'm chanting 16 rounds. I don't feel so good.
现在我念诵十六圈，我感觉不太好。
So I said, "You're a rascal."
我说你是个混账。
You're listening to your mind. Your mind is telling you this is not good.
你在聆听你的心意，你的心意告诉你这个不好。
There are people who say.Why chant so many rounds? We should chant less rounds.
有的人会说，为什么要念诵这么多圈？我们可以念诵的少一点。
They say, I think four rounds is a good number. If I chant four good rounds, it's better than 16 rounds.
有的人说我觉得四圈就挺好的，唱念诵四圈比念诵十六圈要好多了。
But then, if we have four rounds, then some people say, I think one round's enough. Why chant four rounds?
有的奉献者说，我觉得一圈就够了，我还念四圈呢。
And then somebody else will say, why chant one round? I chant one mantra is enough, you know, one pure mantra.
另外有人说，唱诵一圈，念诵一圈干嘛呀？我觉得一个 mantra 就可以了，我可以纯粹的念诵一个 mantra.
So people will always try to compromise. They want to take us away from Krishna.And have more time for mine.
人们总是在进行妥协，想把时间从 Krishna 这儿拿走，然后把更多的时间花在 Maya 那里。
We have to understand the nature of the mind, how it's so cunning.
我们必须要明白到心意的本性是什么，它非常的狡猾。
Right, Bhaktivinoda Thakur describes the nature of the mind. He said it's like a thief who runs away from the crime, and he's shouting, "There goes the thief!"
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 说，心意就好像是一个贼，他犯了罪以后逃跑，然后有人喊，哎，贼在那儿呢。
贼在那儿。There goes the thief. He's over there.
贼就在那里。
So people are like, thief is over there. And he's the thief, but he's putting the attention over some other direction.
然后大家都在找这个贼，可实际上呢，他是贼喊抓贼，他为了转移大家的注意力。
So this is the mind very cunning.
这就是心意非常的狡猾。
We have to be very careful not to fall under the influence of the mind.
我们要非常的小心，不要受到心意的影响。
We want to hear Srila Prabhupada's teaching. What does Srila Prabhupada want us to?
我们要聆听释迦牟尼佛的教导，释迦牟尼佛想让我们做什么？
Prabhupada said chant 16 rounds.
帕帕德说念诵十六圈。
Not less.
不可以少。
And initiated devotees, of course, initiated devotees, we make that vow to chant at least 16 rounds.
当然，这指的是启迪奉献者。启迪奉献者要发誓至少念诵十六圈。
And this way, we're pleasing Srila Prabhupada.
这样我们便在取悦 Srila Prabhupada.
Of course, we can also please Srila Prabhupada in many other ways.
当然我们也可以用很多其他的方法来取悦 Srila Prabhupada.
Now, as we come to the month of December, devotees are getting ready for the Christmas marathon.
我们现在要进入十二月份了，奉献者们准备好进行圣诞节的派出马拉松。
And in the middle of this month, on the 17th actually, I think the 17th is the day in which Krishna spoke the Bhagavad Gita.
我想就在这个月，就十二月十七号的时候，是 Krishna 讲述 Bhagavad Gita 的日子。
They call it sometimes Gita Jayanti.
有的时候大家管这个叫 Gita Jayanti.
So it's a very good day to distribute Bhagavad Gita.
这是一个派发巴格吉塔的好日子。
And there are many devotees who are really going to take advantage of that day to distribute Bhagavad Gitas in big quantities.
有很多的奉献者会充分利用这个日子，大量的派发巴格吉塔。
His Grace Vaisheshika Prabhu is a very active person in book distribution.
尊敬的 Vaisheshika Prabhu, 他是一个非常积极的派书者。
And he has gone to the UK at this time to promote the distribution of the Bhagavad Gita.
这个时候他去了英国，推动对于 Bhagavad Gita 的派发。
Okay, in England there's a lot of Hindus live there.
当然在印度住着很在英国住着很多印度人。
At least 1 million.
至少有一百万。
You know, so, he's, and many of them do business.
他们之中的很多人都做生意。
So, you know, they're not poor, they have money.
所以他们并不贫穷，他们有钱。
And it's by their mercy that we're able to maintain a place like the Bhaktivedanta Manor.
其实是通过他们的仁慈，我们才能够维系得起像 Bhaktivedanta 庄园这样的一个地方。
That Bhaktivedanta Manor is an old building and it takes a lot of money to maintain it.
Bhaktivedanta 庄园是一个很老的一个建筑物，花很多的钱才能够维系它。
So who's going to give the money?
谁来给钱呢？
Do you think the English people will give the money to maintain the Bhaktivedanta Manor?
你们觉得英国人会出钱来维系 Bhaktivedanta 庄园吗？
How do they manage in France, Radhacharan Prabhu?
在法国他们是怎么做的 ？Radhacharan Prabhu.
New Mayapur, how do they maintain that?
他们是怎么维系的？
They're building what?
Cabins.
Yeah. Inside the manor? Inside? Outside?
Cottages.
So.
And they have
the woofers. The woofers. Yeah. 在法国，他们得到了 Jnananda Maharaj 的仁慈，因为他很有力量，可以收集很多的钱，所以他们把整个的城堡都在修葺一新。而且他们还把原来的一些茅屋都改造成单独的一个小单间，还做很多其他的项目。
Yeah, these woofers are quite helpful people.
I don't know how to translate woofer.
Well, we'll explain what the word woofer, what it means.
Woofer 就是说这些人呢非常的有帮助，就是非常的能够帮助我们。
Woofers is a name given to these people who come andhelp on farms, different farm projects, and they will do labor on the land in exchange for a place to stay and their meals.
Woofer 是一种人，就是他们可以去参与你的一些农业项目，通过他们的劳力来换取他们的吃住。
And they're usually quite young people, and they're traveling the world, and you know they just want to stay somewhere for a while.
一般是年轻人在全世界旅行，他们想在一个地方住一段时间。
And they're willing to do a little part-time work in exchange for accommodation.
他们愿意打一些零工，然后呢，可以换取一个地方住。
Right. So they have a lot of woofers there in Australia. I know on the New Govardhan farm there in Australia, they regularly have a number of people there.
在澳大利亚也有很多这样的 woofer， 我知道在新格尔丹的这个农场就有很多这样的人。
And even in Malaysia, we have sometimes some woofers come by, and we have a farm project, and they're happy to stay there.
甚至是在马来西亚也有很多这样的 woofer， 我们也有农场的项目，他们很高兴住在那里。
So they do labor, you know, without you just have to give them prasada.
他们可以打工，他们可以干活，然后你给他们菩萨的就行。
Some of them even become devotees.
甚至其中有一些人成了奉献者。
Yeah, they get introduced to Krishna consciousness.
他们被介绍进了 Krishna 知觉之中。
So it's a nice way of developing a devotee community.
这是一种很好的发展奉献者社团的方式。
You get young people who don't mind working who come.To actually work to do some service.
这样可以吸引一些年轻人，他们不介意干活，他们可以做一些服务。
So we engage them in Krishna's service.
我们便让他们从事于对 Krishna 的服务。
So Krishna consciousness is expanding everywhere.
Krishna 知觉在所有的地方不断的扩展。
There's a lot of nice projects going on.
有很多非常好的项目在进行之中。
Sometimes the temples they go through phases of development and they go down. Like in France, for some time, it was very active and there were many devotees and there was a lot of sankirtan and a lot of preaching going on.
庙宇会经历不同的发展阶段，比如说，就像法国曾经有很多的奉献者，然后大家做很多的 sankirtan。
And then they went through some crisis, and the preaching went down, and the number of devotees also diminished.
然后经历了一些危机，走入低谷，奉献者的人数也大大减少。
But somehow they managed to keep going, and now they're picking up, and it's developing again.
但无论如何他们继续坚持，所以现在再次的开始往上升，然后他们再次得到了发展。
So Krishna consciousness, we said, it doesn't depend on material circumstances.
所以 Krishna 知觉并不依靠任何物质的情况。
Like Prabhupada met Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati and Srila Prabhupada was saying, India is not independent yet. We have to get independence first and then we can spread Lord Chaitanya's teaching.
当我们的舍勒帕布帕见到巴克提斯丹特萨斯瓦提塔库的时候，他说：“现在印度还没有独立，我们应该先让我们的国家独立，然后才能够传播朱彩丹尼的教导。”
But Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati argued back and said, "No, you're wrong. Krishna consciousness cannot wait for some political adjustment."
但是巴克提斯丹特萨斯瓦提反驳他说：“不，不能够再等了。Krishna 知觉并不依靠任何政治上的调整。”
And Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati went on to establish the importance of Lord Chaitanya's movement.
接着巴克提斯丹特萨斯瓦提在确立关于主彩丹尼的运动的重要性。
And that it must be done now. You can't wait. You can't put it off.
必须现在就要做，不能够再等了，不能再拖延了。
So people always, you know, we have the tendency, they have a saying in Mexico, I think it's in Mexico, and they say, or Spain, they say mañana.
Yeah, tomorrow.
Huh?
Tomorrow.
Is it Spanish?
In Spanish,
yeah, they say mañana. You know, you want to do something? Yeah, mañana. Not today, you know, next day. So every day they come, but we do it now? Mañana.
在墨西哥应该是一句西班牙语，他们总是说 mañana， 就是今天不行，回头再说。因为做点什么今天不行，回头再说 mañana。
Yeah, tomorrow means tomorrow。
意思就是明天。
But they're saying it's always tomorrow. You know, even you come tomorrow, they say mañana next.
但是总是明天，你明天来了，他们还说明天。
So we try to put off doing things which need to be done.
这样我们就在一直拖延应该做的事情。
There's a Sanskrit saying, "Subhasya Sigram."
这是一句梵文。
Everybody say, "Subhasya Sigram."
Subhasya Sigram.
Subhasya Sigram.
Subhasya Sigram.
Right. Subhasya Sigram means auspicious things should be done immediately.
Subhasya Sigram 的意思是吉祥的事情应该马上做。
So what is auspicious? Surrender to Krishna should be done immediately.
什么是吉祥的事情？臣服于 Krishna 应该马上做。
Krishna's service should be done immediately.
对 Krishna 的服务应该马上做。
Ravana, he wanted to go to the moon.
Ravana 想去月球。
He was building a staircase to the moon.
他在建一个能够登上月球的梯子。
He was thinking, Why do punya? Just build. I build a staircase. We'll go up the stairs.
他想为什么要做 punya？ 我们直接的就建一个梯子，然后通过梯子就去月球。
But of course he could not finish.
但是当然了，他没有办法完成。
He was always saying mañana.
就跟那句话说的似的 mañana.
But when he saw Sita, when Ravana saw Sita, immediately wanted her.
但是当 Ravana 见到 Sita 的时候，他立刻想要她。
Of course, Mother Sita is the goddess of fortune.
当然 ，Sita 母亲是幸运女神。
And so, his thinking was right, but it was wrong also because Mother Sita is the property of Lord Rama, not his property.
他的想法既对又错，因为 Sita 母亲是主 Rama 的财产，并不是他的财产。
So, Ravana liked people.They all want to enjoy the goddess of fortune, Mother Sita.
像 Ravana 这样的人，他们总是想享受幸运女神西塔母亲。
All these Ravanas, they've all taken the wealth of Mother Sita.
这些 Ravana 们，他们拿走西塔的，西塔母亲的财富。
And Lord Rama was so angry when he came to the ocean across Sri Lanka.He saw the ocean blocking his path to Lanka. Lord Ramachandra looked across the ocean and the ocean became warm. It began to boil and all the living entities in the sea were all disturbed.
主 Rama 非常的生气，他到了海边，他要跨海去 Lanka， 然后他看了这个大海一眼，然后整个的大海开始沸腾，里边所有的水生物都受到了打扰。
We should also be angry to see all the wealth.In the hands of so many Ravana-like people.
当我们看到财富都在像 Ravana 一样的人的手里的时候，我们也应该感到愤怒。
Because that wealth is Mother Sita.
因为那个财富就意味着西塔母亲。
That wealth is the property of the Lord.
那个财富是主的财产。
It's not theirs. It belongs to the Lord.
并不是他们的，那属于主。
And it's meant to be used in the service of the Lord.
而且应该被用于对主的服务。
So our Krishna consciousness movement is meant for that purpose, to bring all the wealth into the service of the Supreme Lord.
所以我们的 Krishna 知觉的运动也是为了这个目的，要把所有的财富用于去服务主。
The people, the Ravana-like people are spending all their wealth in so many sinful ways.
像 Ravana 一样的人，他们把财富都花在了很多罪恶的方面。
What are they doing with their wealth?
他们用他们的财富做什么
？Simply eating, sleeping, mating, defending.
仅仅是吃、睡、交配、防卫。
Eating horrible things.
吃可怕的东西。
They have no discrimination.
他们不做分辨。
Bhagavad Gita said, "Pavritim cha, nivritim cha, jana na vidura sura." That these people who are demonic.They don't know what should be done and what should not be done.
在巴格瓦吉塔之中提到，这些邪恶之人不知道该做什么，不知道不该做什么。
Pavriti, pavriti means what they should do, and nivriti what they should not do.
Pavriti 意味着应该做什么，而 nivriti 就意味着他们不应该做什么。
So Prabhupada explains, we are trying to change that pavriti and nivriti.
所以帕帕说我们想改变这种 poverty 和 nivriti.
These demons are saying, meat, fish and eggs. Give me meat, fish and eggs. Give me illicit sex. Give me drugs. Give me all sinful life.
这些恶魔们在说给我鱼肉蛋，让我吃鱼肉蛋，让我服用麻醉品，让我去赌博，让我去做罪恶的生活。
And we are saying no meat, fish and eggs. No gambling. No illicit sex. No intoxication.
而我们说的是不可以吃鱼肉蛋，不可以服用麻醉品，不可以赌博，不可以做非法性行为。
But we have to change their thinking. What should be done and what should not be done.
我们应该改变他们的想法，应该做什么，不应该做什么。
People don't know. They have no idea.
人们不知道，他们根本就没有概念。
Just like so many young women, they get abortions. They don't know. It's wrong.
就像很多年轻的妇女，她们堕胎，她们并不知道不应该这么做，这是错误的。
Even here in India, it's very common.
甚至在印度这里也成了一件很普通的事情。
You get people coming, you ask them how many abortions you've had, they'll say, oh, nine.
有的时候你问一个人你做了多少次堕胎，他们会说哦，九次。
Just incredible.
不可思议。
We feel.So sorry for the people who are in this condition.
我们为处在这种状况之中的人感觉到非常的难过。
But they will say, I didn't know.
可是他们觉得我不知道。
We have to preach. We have to tell people what is the proper standard for living and acting.
我们要给他们讲，我们要告诉他们生活的还有行为的标准是什么。
So.Krishna consciousness is for education.
因此 ，Krishna 知觉意味着去教育。
Spiritual education.
灵性的教育。
We will see. We have schools here in Mayapur for the children, for younger people. They can go there and get nice education.
我们在马尔普这里看到有学校，那些小孩们可以去上学，可以得到非常好的教育。
And we have also our Mayapur Institute, and in Vrindavan you have the Vrindavan Institute. We have different centers for spiritual education for adults.
而且在马尔普，我们有马尔普学院，在 Vrindavan 有 Vrindavan 学院，我们有不同的机构在灵性的教育方面给成人准备的。
In England, they have a thing called the Bhakti Club.
在英国有他们有这样的一个机构叫做 Bhakti 俱乐部。
俱乐部。Good translation. Yeah, club. Okay. So, education. We say in Chinese, right? Ho dao lao, xie dao lao, hai you san ben xie bu dao. Right? You're never too old to learn. There was a lady this morning, she said, I'm old now, I'm just started Krishna consciousness, but I'm already very old.
今天早晨有一位女士说，我已经很老了，我刚刚开始 Krishna 知觉，可是我年纪很大。
I said, you don't, it's not a problem. I said, we have people who become perfect, even at the point of death.
我告诉她不应该担心，因为我们甚至有人在临死的时候达到完美。
Just like Ajamila.
就像是阿加密拉。
The point of death. Somehow he chanted the holy name.
在死亡的时刻，无论如何，他念诵了主的圣名。
He was saved.
他得到了拯救。
She was saying, "Oh, Narada, he got association when he was a little child. The sadhus came and stayed at his home, and he served them, and they gave him blessings, and he became a great devotee when he was a little boy."
然后他说，好比 Narada， 他小的时候就服务了那些圣人们，那些圣人们祝福了他，然后他得到了圣人的 prasadam， 所以他从小就有这样的基础。
And the lady said, "I'm already old. How will I ever become Krishna conscious?"
这个女士说，我已经年纪这么大了，我怎么能够变得具有 Krishna
知觉？ But I told her, "You can do it. Even at the point of death, you can do it."
但是我告诉她，你可以做得到，即使是在死亡的时刻，你也可以做到。
But don't wait.
但不要等待。
Now, Subhasya Sigram.
现在 Subhasya Sigram.
Now you take up this chanting and you chant very, very seriously, very with great determination and constantly.
现在你就要接受这个念诵唱诵，然后你应该非常有决心的不断的去念诵唱诵。
And in this way, you will be sure to get success in life.
这样你一定会在生命之中取得成功。
It doesn't take a moment to become Krishna conscious.
变得具有 Krishna 知觉，其实并不需要花甚至片刻的时间。
Gadvanga Maharaj had only a moment.
Gadvanga Maharaj 生命之中只剩下片刻。
Gadvanga Maharaj was fighting for the demigods against the demons, and he was really working hard fighting for them, and they were very grateful to him, so they gave him blessings.
Gadvanga Maharaj 在代表半神人跟恶魔打仗，他非常的努力，而且呢，半神人最后决定要给他一些祝福。
So he asked them, they said, "What blessing you want?" He said, "Just tell me how long have I got left in this world?"
半神人问他，你想要什么样的祝福？然后他说，就是告诉我，我在这个世界上还可以活多长时间。
So the demigods told him, "You just have one moment."
半神人们告诉他说，你只剩下片刻的时间。
So, what did he do?
Oh, 那他做了什么？
So, Gadvanga Maharaj came down from the heavenly planets. He came down here.
Gadvanga Maharaj 从天堂星球到了这里，他下来了。
And immediately fixed his mind on the lotus feet of the Lord.
他立刻让自己的心意专注在主的莲花足上。
And went back to Godhead.
回归了守神。
It just takes a moment.
只需要花片刻的时间。
But are you ready to fix the mind?
但是你们准备好了要把你们的心意坚定地住在主的莲花足上了吗？
If we hear, we only have a moment, we'll go,
如果我们要是听说只剩下片刻可活了，我们就吓得
my money, my house.
我的钱，我的家。
My family.
我的家人。
My children.
我的孩子们。
So many attachments we have.
我们有很多的依附。
But Gadvanga Maharaj was ready to just give up everything and take full shelter.
但是 Gadvanga Maharaj 愿意立刻放弃所有的一切，只是托庇于主。
So we also we have to prepare ourselves to fix our mind on Krishna.
所以呢，我们也要准备好，让我们的心意专注在 Krishna 上。
We're practicing.
我们在练习。
We're getting good practice here in Mayapur.
我们在马尔普这里可以得到很好的练习。
One devotee was doing 4 months of austerity, staying in one place and just to observe the Chaturmasya. They spent 4 months staying in one place And just chanting the holy name and doing sadhana, strict sadhana.
有一个奉献者，他在做 chaturmasya 的苦行，他四个月都住在一个地方，然后努力的唱诵、念诵，做他的严格的 sadhana。
And now the 4 months of austerity is over, and then she says, now I'm going, I'll go home, I'm going to my place, I'll go and see my relatives, I'll go and do this, I'll go there.
现在四个月的苦行结束了，他说好了，现在我要离开这里了，我要回家，我要去看我的亲戚，我要干这个，我要干那个。
We are staying in Mayapur 2 years.
我们在马尔普住了两年。
Right.
两年多了，可能是。
Not going anywhere. No
哪儿都不去。
No place to go. No need to go anywhere.
没地儿可去，而且也没法去。
Not just 4 months. We're doing not the chaturmasya. We're doing 2 years of like of nice.Nice, we can do anyway, we should be doing nice austerity, nice practice of sadhana bhakti here in the holy dham.
我们这个不是 chaturmasya, 不是只有四个月，是两年。其实在这里我们可以做很多的很好的苦行，在神圣的 dham.
So this is Krishna's mercy.
这就是 Krishna 的仁慈。
That he gives us this opportunity.Which we may never get in so many lifetimes.
他给了我们这个机会，这是我们很多生生世世都可能得不到的。
In this very special place where the Lord comes in His most merciful form.
因为这个地方非常的特殊，是主以他最仁慈的形象显现的。
So we definitely want to take full advantage of every moment of our time here.
因此我们肯定的是想充分利用我们在这里的每时每刻。
Of all the planets in the material world, this universe is very special.
在所有的星球之中呢，就是在这个宇宙的所有的星球之中，这个星球是非常特殊的。
And in this universe, there are many, many planets, but the Earth planet is very special.
在所有的宇宙之中，这个宇宙非常特殊。在这个宇宙之中，有这么多的星球，在众多的星球之中，这个星球非常的特殊。
And on the Earth planet, there are many places, many countries and islands, different land masses, but the land of Bharatvarsh is very special.
在这个星球，地球上有很多的国家，很多的不同的地方，很多的土地，但是在这个地球上的 Bharatvarsha 这片土地是非常特殊的。
And in Bharatvarsh.There are many places, many holy places, many, but there's one very special place, which is called Gora Mandala Bhumi.
而在 Bharatvarsh 也有很多不同的圣地都是非常特殊的，但是在这个所有的圣地之中，有一个地方非常特殊，叫做 Gora Mandala Bhumi.
Gora Mandala Bhumi is the greater area, not just Navadvipa, but greater area, all the different places, like going over to Ekachakra.And different places like that, which are much further away in, than Ramakeli and these, there are many different places, Panihati, these all different places, Gora Mandala Bhumi.
Gora Mandala Bhumi 这个地域指的是比较广大的一个地方，不仅仅是 Navadvipa, 比如说我们去 Ekachakra, 这个也包括在内，还有 Ramakeli, 然后还有其他的一些地方都可以包括在其中。
Yeah.Sometimes, when the situation improves a little, we can try to plan to go and visit some of these places.
等到情况好转一些的时候，我们可以计划去拜访这些地方。
Go to Ekachakra.
去 Ekachakra.
And then from Ekachakra, can go to see Kanainatsala.
从 Ekachakra, 我们可以去看 Kanainatsala.
We have ISKCON temples there.
我们在那儿有一个伊斯康的庙
，very special places，
非常特殊的地方。
Then there's also Panihati，
然后还有 Panihati。
Panihati is very near Calcutta。
Panihati 离加尔各答很近。
Just not far from the airport。
离机场很近。
We have a temple there。
我们在那儿也有一个庙。
And an important place of the pastimes of Raghunath Das Goswami。
那个地方是一个 Raghunath Das Goswami 上演逍遥时光的重要的圣地。
那 the There's a temple there, land which was purchased by His Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami.
那个地方有庙宇，我们还有土地是由圣座 Bhakti Charu Swami 购买的。
So Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda, they used to go there to this place, Panihati.
诸钱坦涅、诸尼天南达，他们常常去这样的地方，比如说像 Panihati.
And they have the Panihati Shiradhi Festival.
而且还会举行 Panihati Shiradhi 节日。
Right. Every year, still they celebrate Panihati Shiradhi Festival.
仍然到现在，大家每一年都要庆祝 Panihati Shiradhi 节日。
So it's nice to go and visit these places.
如果去访问这些地方是一件很好的事情。
And then Ganga Sagar.
然后还有 Ganga Sagar.
Ganga Sagar is Kapila Muni's ashram.
Ganga Sagar 是 Kapila Muni 的 ashram.
Kapila Muni still resides there.
Kapila Muni 仍然住在那里。
I don't know if you'll get to see him though.
不过我不知道你们能不能见到他。
But he's there.
但他是在那儿的。
And every year in the month of January, they have a big mela.
每一年的一月份，他们在那里举行一个很大的 mela.
Many people, thousands of people go.
有很多人，成千上万的人都会去。
And the devotees also go.
奉献者们也会去。
Do sankirtan, do preaching, book distribution.
做 sankirtan, 做传播，做派发书籍的活动。
They say.If you go to visit holy places, you have to visit Ganga Sagar at least one time.
据说如果你们要是去绕拜圣地的话，至少应该有一次去 Ganga Sagar.
And we're building an ISKCON temple there.
我们在那个地方在建设一座伊斯康的庙宇。
And we'll be opening sometime soon.
很快的就会开幕。
So these are very, very wonderful places.
这些都是非常奇妙的地方。
Ganga Sagar, where the Ganga flows into the sea.
Ganga Sagar 是恒河入海的地方。
You have to take boat to go there.
我们要坐船才能去那儿。
But very would be very nice to go there.
如果能去那儿就太好了。
Bhaktivinoda Thakur prays in his song Shuddha Bhakta.You know the song, Shuddha Bhakta?
Shuddha Bhaktivinoda Thakur 在他的歌曲 Shuddha Bhakta 之中有一个赞美，然后你们都知道这个歌怎么唱吗？ Shuddha Bhakta.
Shuddha Bhakta is one of the songs in a book of songs. Bhaktivinoda wrote a book of songs called Sharanagati, meaning surrender.
Shuddha Bhakta 这首歌呢是在 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 写的一个歌集里边，这个歌集叫做 Sharanagata, 意思是臣服。
And there are six items of surrender.
有臣服的六个方面。
Right? Lalita Pran, you remember? You studied Bhakti Shastri? Right? Six items. One of the items, the first item, to accept everything favorable for devotional service.
臣服六个方面，其中的第一个方面是接受一切有利于奉献服务的事情。
So Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote songs about each of the different items of surrender.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 撰写了关于臣服的每一个方面的内容。
So this song, Shuddha Bhakta, this is about all the things which are favorable for devotional service.
因此这首名叫 Shuddha Bhakta 的歌曲描述了所有一切有利于我们奉献服务的事物。
Right, Shuddha Bhakta Charana Renu Bhajana Anukula Bhakta Seva Paramasiddhi Premalati Karamula Bhaktivinoda Thakur is describing the dust from the feet of the pure devotees.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur 描述了来自于纯粹奉献者足下的尘土。
The water which has washed their feet.
而且还有洗他们足的浊足水。
The remnants of their foodstuff.
他们的食物的觊觎。
This is how you get the mercy.
这。
This is accepting these items. It helps us to get the mercy of Krishna.
这便是如何得到仁慈的方法。接受这些事物可以帮助我们得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
And he said, "May I always visit all the holy places associated with the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu."
而且他提到，我什么时候能够拜访所有跟主 Chaitanya Prabhu 上，主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 上演逍遥时光有关的所有的那些圣地呢？
This is what we should be doing when we're here in Mayapur.
这就是我们应该做的。当我们在 Mayapur 的时候，在这里。
Go to see the different holy places.
去看那些不同的圣地。
And hear about Lord Chaitanya's pastime.
并且聆听主 Chaitanya 的逍遥时光。
So this is surrender to Krishna.
这就是对 Krishna 的臣服。
It's trouble. We know it's trouble. We have a nice room. We're comfortable here. Why I need to go anywhere?
这是麻烦。我们知道这个很有麻烦。我们在这儿有很好的一个房间，我们为就已经很舒服了。为什么要去别的地方
？But we have to accept that little austerity in order to purify ourselves.
但是为了净化我们自己，我们必须要接受这一丁点的苦行。
We don't want.Like the birds, they build their nests. They want to have their nest. They want to be in one place.
就像鸟儿，他们会建自己的巢穴，他们想住在一个地方。
They try to move into our buildings.
他们想搬进我们的楼里住。
We say, "Go back to the tree. You're supposed to live in the trees."
然后我们跟他们说，你应该回到树上去，你们应该住在树上。
But they say, "Well, you knocked down all the trees. We're coming to live in your building."
然后这些鸟儿们说：“你们把树都砍了，所以我们只能跑到你们楼里来住。”
They always have to get out, send them away.
他们总是说：“走开，走开。”
They always come back.
但他们总是回来。
So we have to be also detached from our material conditions.
我们不应该依附于我们物质的条件。
We want to cultivate our Krishna consciousness.
我们想。培养我们的 Krishna 知觉。
And Mayapur is a very good place to do it.
Mayapur 是做这件事情的一个非常好的地方。
We have to be grateful for this opportunity.
我们应该因为得到了这个机会而非常感激。
Okay, any question?
有什么问题吗？
Any comments, Radhacharan Prabhu?
有什么评论吗， Radhacharan Prabhu?你可以讲点什么吗？我想您讲得非常的好，因为对奉献者而言，能够住在神圣的大姆，这是一个很好的机会。有的时候奉献者们在想，我现在在大姆，但我想的是我的传播的这个服务。然后当我想到我的传播的服务的时候，我便想到我在神圣的大姆待着能干什么呀。但无论如何，用哪种方式，我们都必须要让神圣的大姆留在我们的知觉之中。
Yes, anybody else?
是的，还有其他人吗？
Okay, then we'll have some kirtan.
那我们接着做一些 kirtan 吧。Thank you.